This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is rate conversions, example one, also called unit or dimensional analysis. This video is part of a series of videos on rate conversions. Make sure you have already watched my videos on unit conversions before you try the rate conversions. All right, here is our first example. If a car is traveling 65 miles per hour, what is its speed in kilometers per hour? Use the conversion factor. 1 mile is approximately 1.6 kilometers. All right, so let's see. We're starting off with 65 miles per hour. So we can write that as 65 miles per 1 hour. Now, if 1 mile equals 1.6 kilometers, you want to multiply this by something, right? We'll try to figure out what to multiply it by. We want to end up with kilometers per hour, right? Kilometers per hour means we want the kilometers in the numerator and we want hours in the denominator. Well, I already have hours in the denominator, so that's okay. So somehow we have to go from miles to kilometers. And it's this conversion right here that we'll use. Now, just keep in mind this is not exact, so our answer will be approximate. So let's see. I want to have the kilometers in the numerator, so my answer ends up with kilometers an hour and hours. And we want to get rid of the miles. So if I take this 1 mile over 1.6 kilometers, we know that equals 1 because these are approximately the same. Or we could write that as the 1.6 kilometers is the same thing as 1 mile. So we want to choose one of these for our conversion factor, for our new fraction. So I want the miles to cancel. So I'm going to use this one right here, right? So that the miles will cancel and I'll get kilometers in the numerator. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to multiply this by the fraction that equals 1. Remember, these fractions equal 1 because the numerator and denominator represent really the same thing. So we've got 1.6 kilometers. And in the denominator, we've got 1 mile. And let's see, if we cancel the mile with the mile, notice I will have for my units, I'll have kilometers in the numerator and hours in the denominator, which is what we want. So all we have is this multiplication, 65 times 1.6. So everybody do that either on a piece of paper or in your calculator. And that should give you 104. So you get 104, and you have kilometers per hour, right? So you could write that as 104 kilometers over an hour, or the more common way to do this is to just write 104 kilometers per hour. Not sure if that showed up on my screen, so I'm going to move this over just a little bit. Okay, it's more common to see it written like that. So that's our answer, 104 kilometers per hour. So if you are in a car that is the speedometer is in miles per hour, it would say 65 miles per hour. And some cars show you also what it is in kilometers per hour. It should show up at about 104 kilometers per hour. Again, this is not exact. It might be 105 or something like that. It'll be, you know, in the ballpark because it really is not exactly equal right here. In fact, if you want, you could use little squiggly signs to show it's approximately equal to that, not exactly equal to that.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.